some of the properties of objects in Processbook are read-only. And it doesn't seem to make sense why they're read-only until you take a look at this next example. For example, here's a Processbook trend. Now, if we look at this using, I'll just create a quick little subroutine, I'll just call it test one. Here's a subroutine called test one, and what I'd like to do is just demonstrate a read-only property. So I'm going to say let's do a message box that shows this display.trend. Let's look at the start time. Now if I go ahead and run this, I'll do F8 to bring up the list of functions here. As you can see, it works just fine. Here's a read-only property. It's *-8 hours, and in fact that is the start time. If we look right here, that's the start time. I switch this to *-1 day, of course, and run this, then we'll get a different answer. There we go. So we're able to get to it that way, but why can't we simply modify it either here or in the properties box? Why can't we say we're going to set the start time equal to, say, *-8 days? Watch what happens when I try that. I try to run this, we'll get an error message. Basically, it's an invalid property assignment. The reason we don't support this is because we want to be able to give you the better or the best error messaging we can if somebody makes a mistake by assigning the wrong start time or end time. See, for properties that you really can't get wrong, we don't really care what you, we don't care to have the best error trapping for that. I'll give you an example. Within trend, you know, there's things like fill color. If you decide to put the wrong fill color or a different fill color, we're not going to trap an error like that. We're not concerned about that, but we are concerned that you may use a start time or end time that's invalid. So what we do for that is we force you, instead of doing that, to simply do this display.trend and use the, this is set start and end time. Where is it? Set start and end time. Set start and end time takes the arguments of the start and the end time. We'll go *-8 days. And since it is a method instead of a property, we have better tools for, you know, for showing you error messages that may be generated. There's a variable we can look at, or it's an object that we can look at in the immediate window, called application last error code and last error message. And see, this is something that's it's very easy for us to get to and to write to this last error message if you are doing this within the context of a method. If you're just trying to set a property like you see right here, it's not very easy for us to get to that. So instead, for certain of these things, we do want to force you to use a method. So that's why, for example, to change the scale max and the scale min, there's a set trace scale. So let's take a look at how this runs. This should, in fact, change this for us. I'll go ahead and run this. And as you can see, this assignment works just fine. And if we did have some kind of an error message, we'd see that error message show up in this last error message.